that note, welcome again to the PDC Network presents you Music Inc. 4.0 Virtual Summit, an initiative by Loudest and supported by Exchange for Media and BW Business World. Let's get straight into what's coming up next. Now, this is going to be one of the most delightful sessions to hear from. Somebody who represents IT world, but stands out on the group to represent the group to take it forward. Someone who masters every single day with her voice. Ladies and gentlemen, our next keynote speaker is somebody who's a CMO and IBM India and South Asia, is the first woman to host a business and leadership podcast. The podcast series is called Being CEO with Dipali Nair. Continuing with her passion for podcasts, the keynote by the one and only here at Music Inc. Delighted to welcome the CMO, IBM India and South Asia, Miss Dipali Nair with us this morning. And I'm so delighted. Hello, ma'am. Good morning to you. Happy World Music Day.
I will answer that in my keynote, Mithin, for sure.
All right.
That's one of the things I want to talk about. But meanwhile, I'm looking forward to you recording a Punjabi song now, huh?
Yes, ma'am. I'm going to start writing right now.
Yeah. Okay.
Over to you, ma'am. Can't wait to hear from you. Over to you. Have a good
Thank one. You, Mithin. Thank you. Really appreciate, I think, the opportunity from Ruhail and the Business World team and, Music Inc. I think what is delightful for me today, as I wish you good morning to all of you, is that I think podcast is also getting a voice. This is Music Inc., and the fact that this new kind of sound, is also becoming mainstream, I think is the most delightful thing for me today. And let me just, share with you, KPMG's Media and Entertainment Report 2020 found that India recorded about 30% increase in podcast consumption in the first 12 months of the pandemic. And if I look at Pricewaterhouse's, PwC's Global Entertainment and Media Outlook report, India is the third largest consumer of podcasts after US and China. We have about 57 million monthly listeners to podcasts. This is the data. HT Smartcast, which is the podcasting wing of HT Media, saw its listenership grow exponentially from March last year to this year. Awaaz.com has seen its numbers double in the last 1 year, now at 1 million+ listeners. That's a platform that my podcast is on. But these numbers, and Mithin asked me, why not an article, why not a book? These numbers are not the reason I decided to podcast. I decided to podcast because being CEO, Mithin, was an original content idea. In 2018, I really examined that any literature about Indian professional CEOs just doesn't exist. If you pick up any book, if you pick up any literature, HBR articles, McKinsey articles, there are lots of frameworks about leadership. They're all modeled on CEOs in the West. There are lots of stories of CEOs in the West. The Indian startups and unicorn founders are being celebrated, but not the Indian CEOs. We have something unique in this country, and I felt that these stories needed to be told. Who are these people behind the revenue growth? Who are these people, behind a market cap going up? Who are these people, which are really making the Sensex and the Nifty go up? Where do they come from? What is their model of leadership? And, to answer your question that you asked me, I was all set to write about it. Maybe a monthly column or maybe a book someday, but I was ready to write about it, except that I never did, because I think the podcast was meant to be. Multiple serendipitous incidents, I think, led me to a podcast. One of the incidents that I now credit, is that I never found the time in my hectic schedule before COVID to start the column. Two, that I ran into Sri, which is Sri Raman. He is the founder of Awaaz.com. I ran into him in Delhi on March 6th, 2020. That was just before the lockdown got announced. And I ran into him after a decade. Three, we were on the same flight the next day, which is on March 7th. 4, I don't know why I decided to tell him about the column that I was not finding time to write, right? So I said it is all about serendipity. The 5th serendipitous, you know, incident, he told me during the flight, why write? Why not just speak? I was flattered at his confidence in my idea and my ability, but still the podcast almost did not happen. You know, I really thought that she was being polite and, you know, so on and so forth. But sometimes in April, one of my college batchmates, Sunil Kumar, he called me up and told me, he's saying, listen, Dipali, I think you've got a wonderful voice, the way you talk. And I think you should talk a lot more on the learning and development side. He'd seen one of the, you know, videos that I had recently done. You know, he about, you know, learnings from COVID, etc. Another friend reacted to a voice note. And some of you who know me, you know that I have a habit of sending voice notes on WhatsApp. You know, this friend messaged me back and said, Dipali Mangeshkar. Of course, I was flattered, you know, all, you know, respect to, you know, the word Mangeshkar. I was flattered, but I was also surprised. But, you know, these 3 votes of confidence from Shri, from my friend Sunil, another friend who, you know, another friend Ajay, who sent me back this. With these 3 incidents, I spoke to my family. I actually asked my mom if I had a good voice. Mom's being mom, she told me I had a fantastic one. Next call was to my brother to ask him the same thing. And of course, I turned around and told my family why no one ever told me this before, you know, as if, you know, I was going to have a career, you know, in sound. But yes, you know, with a sense of this whole, you know, feedback that I'd got, the disbelief also, I called Shri and I really interrogated him. This is the founder of Awaaz I'm talking about. I literally interrogated him, although, you know, I asked him why he thinks that I would do a good job of a podcast. And of course, he would never say that I interrogated him because I'm just so polite in the way I talk. But I really quizzed him. And thank God he managed to convince me that I should, you know, definitely do a podcast. And that's when started the real hard work. I burnt the midnight oil listening to podcasts from around the world. You know, I wanted to ensure that my idea was truly original, that nobody was doing what I had in mind, which is telling the stories of Indian CEOs. This research was very useful, you know, to prove one more hunch I had, that typically the podcasts are 45 minutes to an hour. And I've always felt that that was a little too long. That was my personal hunch. I felt after doing all the research that there was room for a business podcast for about 30 minutes, a little shorter, sweeter, therefore, according to me. See, the research also told me, you know, that no other woman in India was doing a mainstream business or a leadership podcast. That strengthened my resolve even more to do it. There are fantastic women podcasters, but they were doing podcasts on women leadership, women heroes, parenting, but nobody was doing it on a mainstream leadership topic. And, you know, so that's when I really decided that, okay, now I have to do it. One of the very strong elements, you know, I was doing it. But the clincher was that, you know, Awaaz as a platform really appealed to me, you know, the CMO in me, really. They had a very, very deep analysis of their audience and who they were. Their English listeners were predominantly young professionals. And I saw a huge match of how my content would appeal to these young professionals. You know, the last section of my podcast, that is the rapid fire that's been devised, is clearly driven for appeal to this audience. You know, so that's how, like I say, the matches happen, match made in heaven. And then comes in another coincidence, you know. The serendipity is that I'm a talk show buff. I have in my life consumed hours and hours of talk shows, you know, be it Oprah or Ellen or Karan Johar or Jimmy Fallon, Jimmy Kimmel, Graham Norton, or even James Lipton's Inside the Actor Studio, which is absolutely my favorite, and Javed Akhtar hosting, you know, classic legends. I mean, my favorite program on Doordarshan in my growing up years was not Chitrahar. It was Phool Khile Hain Gulshan Gulshan, you know, the talk show. So let me say this. I used to be a big fan of even, you know, Pranoy Roy when he used to do the interviews. That's years and years of research just sitting in my head, I think was perhaps, you know, another serendipity. My dummy podcast that I did, you know, with Awaaz team was a huge validation that I had something going. And then, of course, you know, methodically came the plan. I am the editor in chief, you know, for, you know, being CEO with Dipali Nair. I record only on weekends so that my work commitments don't get compromised. The structure of questions, the guest list that we drew up, all of this, you know, which I kind of editorial control. But I think what Awaaz offers me is great production values, you know, so on and so forth. But, you know, in hindsight, why did I really do it? Why did I decide to podcast? I think it was this whole call of doing something new, doing something which where I would get treated like a content creator. You know, I've done well on, let's say, LinkedIn and Twitter in terms of social media. And therefore, this whole thing of proving to the Gen Zs in your team that any new medium is something that, you know, we marketers can dominate, and that, you know, the strategic things that we've learned over the years can be translated into great content strategy. I think in hindsight, that was also something that was egging me on. One, of course, that there was no female in the mainline, you know, podcasting scene in India on leadership domain. And second was also this, you know, lot of youngsters, you know, don't believe that we oldies have it. And a lot of my friends who are my age group believe that we don't have it. And I somehow want to prove them wrong. So, you know, then that's when this thought cropped up that I'm going to be representing a whole set of people, it also made us very careful. Of course, I'm the marketing person that I am, and we tick all the boxes. So I didn't let the Awaaz team, you know, release the podcast till I had 8 episodes already recorded in. They typically do it with 3 or 4. I had 8 episodes before we actually launched. And the results are there for us to see. Today we are at 29 episodes. And like I told you, Awaaz gives me statistics which I really, you know, enjoy and value, which some other platform I may not be able to get. We have, at episode 15, we had 52% retention rate. At episode 29, we have 58% retention rate. The average on the Awaaz platform is, you know, in 2 digits, but like way, way below 20%. What this means is that every person who comes in, you know, listens to 58% of them listen to all the episodes. We've spent $0. 0 rupee has been spent marketing this program. And yet we have thousands of listeners and completing, you know, all the episodes. The beauty is we've of course also got 3-4 awards. I've been, you know, at an Asia level recognized at a content creating forum as the top 15, you know, Asian, you know, women from content creation, best podcast listing, you know, 40 over 40 women in trying something new and risky, you know, all that. But I think the love and the anecdotes that I get on Twitter, the messages that I get and ask where people are asking me when's the next episode coming, I think is a matter of joy, and which validates that I think my decision to podcast, you know, was the right decision. A lot of the times I'm also asked, how do I balance being the CMO and, you know, being the podcaster that I am? And I think that's a very careful, you know, time management juggle that I do. I'm really, and I want to use this forum to say this, I'm very indebted to the producer of my show, who is always willing to record with me on a Saturday, Sunday. Very, very indebted to every guest that I've had on the show, whom we've managed to convince that Saturday, Sundays are a good day to record this podcast. You know, we've kind of managed to do that, barring, I think, 2 exceptions out of the 30 episodes that we've recorded. They've always been on the weekend. I burn a lot of midnight oil, you know, for doing this, but it's really worth it, because I think my diary is full for the next few months. Every weekend, I'm invited to speak to some B-school or the other, or invited to speak like today, you know, about podcasting or sharing the leadership lessons, you know, that I have given. Personally, very, very fulfilling, because I think every session that I've done with my CEOs is extremely, you know, knowledgeable and like a mentoring session for me. Now, let's go back to why I think today that this idea works. And why I think that this original stories of talking about the people behind the CEO corner office works. I'll go back to the 3 A's framework, you know, that I have developed. And I've often spoken about it, that the 3 A's framework, which is authenticity, ability, agility, these 3 A's framework, you can use to judge whether as a marketing team you're doing a great job. You can use it as a quick check to judge whether as a brand you're doing a good job. The same framework will also apply to your personal brand. Are you authentic? Do you have the ability? Are you agile? And I think it's the same framework, because it exists in my mind, we ended up applying, you know, to the podcast too. And when I was thinking about doing the keynote today, I was making notes last night. When I think about the authenticity, the idea is original. The branding is original. The content is original. You can't find anything like this anywhere else. The style is also original. It's a conversation. We make the guests extremely comfortable, and you can hear the laughter in our voices, when you listen to the podcast. This podcast has not been done for self-promotion. This podcast has not been done because, a brand needed a voice to talk about, you know, what the brand stands for. Not at all. This is far, far removed from, I think, any brand promotion in that sense. And that's the authenticity. And that's why I think I have thousands of listeners without us spending a single dollar. The word of mouth has ensured that the podcast has 58% retention rate and thousands listen to it. The second bit that I mentioned, agility. As the content framework that we had developed, you know, we did the first 6 episodes, and then we did another 6, and then another 6, and we are on the 30th episode. But no 2 questions are alike that we're asking to the guests. This is about them. That agility is built into the system. The way we record, the technicality of the recording is also extremely agile. And the content framework is also extremely, agile. And you've got to listen to a couple of episodes, for you to realize that, none of them are alike, to each other. And there is this freshness. And the third bit I mentioned, ability, which, let's say, for a marketing team is about the skills they have, the MarTech stack they have, and so on and so forth. That ability over here, I think the fact that I chose to work with Awaaz, who is very advanced in terms of data and statistics, that kind of ability, the technical part of recording production values, so on and so forth, I think that's wonderful. The ability of being able to network with the guests, almost every guest that we've had is handpicked, is extremely important. And I want to go back on this authenticity, agility, ability framework, just to say this, that we decided from an editorially, policy perspective, that we will only record with the CEOs who are professionals. We're getting tons of requests from startup CEOs. We're getting tons of requests from founder CEOs. We may start another series for them, someday, but we've not kind of compromised so that we are true to the listeners, that we have. So Mithun, you did ask me, why I decided to podcast. This in short is the story of why I decided to podcast. The fact that, I had a point to prove about, maybe women podcasters, maybe serendipity was taking me there. I think the fact that there was an authentic content idea that needed to be told, and maybe it didn't happen earlier because column is perhaps not the best way of, narrating the stories. Third is, the storytelling, that the narrative of a talk show host, the years and years of research, like I mentioned. And it was an idea that was going to take off at the time that it took off. I launched in July 2020, and podcasts across the world have seen the highest level of growth in the last 12 months. So, we were ahead of the curve in terms of, doing it. There are many others who've done podcasts before me, and I want to mention, one is Varun, who runs Advertising Is Dead, and I was invited on his podcast, and that's when I actually became familiar of, what podcasting is all about. We're also authentic. I want to go back to authenticity, agility, and ability. We're also authentic because we've stuck to the format of the podcast, which is audio listening. We haven't, mixed it up with, videos too. So I think that authenticity is also, extremely important, to us. I want to end by saying that I think podcasting or voice, and I know this is musicking, podcasting or voice, or voice tech, or voice-based content is here to stay. And to me, it's also about you know, finding something to say. If you've got something to say and you are currently using, let's say, a Twitter or a LinkedIn to express yourself, then I think you should consider Clubhouse or a podcast platform. Because if you have a voice and if you can write, I think then you can speak too. To me, podcasting is like, the new social media. If I have a voice and if I want to tell a story, I could have easily used a LinkedIn Live. I could have easily done in interviews, on video and put them out. And that would have been, my social media content on LinkedIn. But I think I chose to do it through a podcast. A lot of people listen to it, while they're running, driving, exercising. I think you must find the format that best suits you. But I think today, because we are at this conference at Music Inc., I think the numbers that I shared, the growth rates that we are having in the podcast medium is what everybody should remember. Most, OTT platforms should think of themselves being in the sound business. I mean, this is the marketer in me talking. I know that music and songs form the bulk of it, and they will perhaps continue to do so till times immemorial. But I think they must look at themselves in the business of voice, because that's when new formats, new content, new voices, will truly be heard. So I'm, very, very grateful to Shri that a chance encounter and a flight together, have probably bonded us forever through these episodes that we have on being CEO with Dipali Nair. It's a juggernaut that's not stopping. We at one point of time had thought 25 episodes and that's it. And we keep on getting requests from guests who have beautiful stories to tell. That's where we are. I'm delighted to have been invited today over here. Thank you very much. And I'm delighted to tell the story of why I decided to podcast. I hope you enjoyed, what I shared with you. And do remember the framework: authenticity, agility, and ability. I think that's a hallmark of good content also. And that's the hallmark of a good marketing team. And that's the hallmark of a good brand. Mithun, thank you very much. Back to you.
Thank you so much, ma'am. I won't let you go just like that, because firstly, thank you for answering the question. What I heard, the first 10 minutes, I could just close my eyes and imagine listening to a podcast, and I could feel the vibrance of your voice that is catching up with every single word that you speak. So I know you're far from me right now, but I can always give a big round of applause for being so vocal about it. Indeed, it just made me so confident about being more loud, more vocal, and speak up.
Yeah, so, thank you, Mithun. Thank you.
Indeed, it was a pleasure having you on board. I know. I've been asking all of the speakers to give me a quote and describe music in one word or a sentence. But I would want you to sing a line for me, because you have such an amazing voice. I know you're waiting for me to write a Punjabi song and sing, but right now I'm going to play something, and I want you to please sing with me. Anything you start with?
So I don't have a singing voice. I have a wonderful podcasting voice. And I must, complete that anecdote. My mom actually got fed up and asked me, and she said, "Why are you asking us so much? You've got a good voice. Just, be okay with it." And I actually told her, I said, "Why didn't you tell me this earlier?" And she said, "Pehle bata dete to kya hota tha?" And I told her, "RJ ban jati main agar pehle bata dete to." So no, I don't have a good singing voice, but I think there is a message that I wanted to say, which is very befitting for voice industry. And I think it's music. I mean, I love music. I am constantly listening to Indian songs. I'm a complete Bollywood music buff. Okay, so here goes. I will try and hum it, but I'm not very good at it.
And I will add some music to the background.
But I think focus on the lyrics, Mithun, okay? Focus on the lyrics, okay? Yes. एक दिन बिक जाएगा माटी के मोल जग में रह जाएंगे प्यारे तेरे बोल ला 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 ला
Absolutely. What a best way to describe this entirely musically. Thank you so much for joining us here, giving us your story, your side of story. And we were delighted to hear from you. Thank you so much. I wish you a very happy World Music Day and a very happy International Yoga Day. But more than that, I wish you great success in the being CEO with the Pali Nayyar. Thank you so much again and have a great day. God bless you.